Good afternoon, everybody. General Punjab, Chief Minister, General Secretary, the Vice Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Ranjan Prasad, Signal Officer Chief, Major General Milin Bhuke, Chief Tech Communication, General Energy Director General CII, Media Friends, Ladies and Gentlemen. I am very happy to address this distinguished gathering of senior officers from Armed Forces, Indian Industry, Academia, and the organization. It gives me great pleasure to see that a joint and collaborative approach is being taken to strong the infrastructure and skilled human resources from digital army. At the outset, let me compliment Corps of Signal for focusing on the need to fast-track transformation to a digital army and organizing this seminar. As earlier brought out, information and data abilities has transformed leave to rally. Similarly, the rapid advances in information and communication technologies are today driving changes in the way future wars will be conducted in the digital battlefield. In a government, we realize the importance of information and enabled services for all citizens. The Digital India Initiative of our Honorable Prime Minister is aimed at creating digitally empowered society. Similarly, the information security of earlier can empower military commandants at all levels to ensure a continued military dominance. Future war will be fought under the gaze of omniscient sensor. And given improved weapon system, they will be more intense and shorter duration. The telescoping of time and space will place much greater stress on military decision makers than in the past. Hence, information will be one of the most important force multiplier, not just in non-kinetic operation as in recent years. It will significantly transform the conduct of kinetic operations also. I would like to assure that the progress of infrastructure for digital and based on state-of-the-art technology is a top priority for us in government. We would like this initiative of creation of operation information to be expedited at all levels. The robust, secure, high-capacity data networks and information system are an urgent necessity for operational compass. Classical asset for the fourth modern nation of India. Further, they will form the for trial services integration in time to come. I'm also thrilled to note the keen participation from the Indian industry, academia, and other organizations in the competition. Of course, the creation of infrastructure for digital army will need indigenous institutions and system the print of your security. More importantly, the creation of indigenous capabilities in ICT sectors will give a major relief to make the program, which is a flagship initiative of our government. Also, in the presence of ever-changing landscape of cybersecurity threats, indigenous capability of ICT will play a major role in protection of critical information infrastructure in the civil domain also. Suitable induction for the government uses as well as in other sectors like banking, power, etc. will certainly be driven by the secure infrastructure which will be developed for the digital army. The Indian industry needs to seize this opportunity for dual-use technology in the right earnest. Having seen the sub-theme for the sessions planned during DEFCON 2017, what caught my eyes was the content has been designed in such a manner that discussion is not reduced to the level of mere technology scans or educational awareness programs. It was encouraging to see the subtopic listed in each sessions are actually contemporary requirements. These requirements are rightly aimed at realistic appraisal of emerging technologies to arrive. I applaud this ability to raise a correct question prior to the planning and design stages. This will result in reduced life cycle cost. More importantly, given the brilliance of Indian minds, which is evident from the fact that almost all major global firms have Indian CEOs. If we ask the right question, the Indian system comprising of all of you distinguished persons will always manage to find the right answers. I would like you all to contribute in full measure to mutual collaborative efforts in DevCon 2017, and also to carry this synergy forward to help create reliable infrastructure for India's digital army in the shortest possible time frame and the most cost-effective manner. Suggestions from SONC to create a separate category for fast-track procurement for ICT equipment, which is very severely and rapidly affected by the technology obsolescence, is a very good suggestion. To use his own words, it will be the biggest takeaway that I have gained from DevCon 2017. I will follow up with the staff in the ministry. The inclusion of content on satellite and space application is indeed timely. With integrated regional navigation satellite system, that is IRNSS, having been launched, the recognition of need to exploit IRNS restricted services in military system is of paramount importance. DevCon 17 will throw more light on the development and exploration. On the very technical end, focus and create in DevCon 2017, another remarkable aspect I found was that full session has been devoted to the human resources and organization aspect. I would like to emphasize that what makes it unique in the case of armed forces is that every man who ventures into battle must do so with unmatched pride and confidence. That can only happen when we, the planners, the designer, the manufacturer, and even sailors are able to instill such pride and confidence in the man behind the machine on the battlefield that the nation stands strongly behind him. That confidence can only come when he knows that weapon he fights with, the radio he uses, the satellite that he relies upon, the data center that keep him informed. All of these are the best in the world because they have been created by the best of Indian minds. That's, ladies and gentlemen, is what should drive your informed discussion during DevCon 17. Before I conclude, I compliment the Chief of Army Staff and SONC for having enabled this participative, collaborative spirit of DevCon. I also compliment the Corps of Signals and CII and wish them all the very best for the successful conduct of DevCon 2017. I am confident that useful insights which get generated during DevCon 2017 will lead to synergized national endeavor, which is required for infrastructure of Indian digital army. I end by stating that as a Raksha Rajya Mantri, and more so as a proud Indian citizen, I would like to put on the record the immense pride that I have in Indian Armed Forces in general and the Indian Army in particular. May the journey towards the digital army be free of any hindrance whatsoever. I wish you all very best.